Hey everybody, did you miss me? I know you did. It's been like a week. What can I say? I had to move. It was a hectic, crazy time. But we're back, all right? Newest episode of The Bearded Gamer Show. And as always, I'm your host with the beard, awesome beard, Chris Arnone, The Bearded Gamer, of course. How about we talk comics with the pull list? So as always, Wednesday is New Comic Book Day. What does that mean? It means you should go and find your local comic book shop. Go visit your local comic book guru and find out what awesome things you should be reading, in addition to, of course, this great list I've got for you. So first up, Daredevil number 12, Marvel Comics as always. Now, Mark Waid has just been knocking it out of the park on Daredevil the entire run so far. It's one of the highest reviewed books, ongoing books of the year, and it's just fantastic. And now he and Rivera are going to be welcoming a new artist, Chris Samnee, to the book. And this issue, they're going to be Matt Murdock out of his red tights, pursuing a little love with an assistant district attorney. But don't worry, there'll still be plenty of blind ass kicking going on. It looks like a really great title and a new arc. Good place to jump in. All right. Next up, we have Dial H number one. Now, this just looks really cool. So there's this ancient artifact that looks like an old telephone. You dial it up and you get some superpowers. And so this guy has found this and you know, started doing this stuff. And he's getting really addicted to it and finds out that this artifact, what's giving him superpowers, is also threatening the entire DC universe. And they're really going to dig into a lot of sort of really offbeat and weird superheroes and supervillains from the DCU. And it's written by... I hope I don't mispronounce this, China Mayville, who is a Nebula Award winner. Very prestigious science fiction award. And this title just looks really cool. It's got sort of that indie vibe, and yet it's set in the DCU using all these great DCU characters. So I highly recommend go pick up Dial H number one. Next up, I love the name of this, Epic Kill number one. Okay, so the president has hired all these different mercenaries and hitmen to go after this one 18-year-old girl. Well, she's not so sweet and innocent. See, her parents were killed, and she has become a super assassin bent on revenge. Oh yeah, and the guy who killed her parents, that would be the newly elected president, hence why he's trying to kill her before she kills him. And the title is promising that every kill will be epic. Very much got a sort of a Scott Pilgrim or Wanted kind of vibe. I definitely dig it. Go check that one out. And now my final recommendation of this week. Gonna dig back a little into the 90s. Exo Manowar number one. Eric is back. Valiant is back. They're bringing it back in 2012. And of course, they're kicking it off with Exo Manowar. Now they've got just a great lineup of talent behind this one, okay? New York Times bestselling author Robert Venditti is writing it, and the art is by an Eisner winner by the name of Kerry Nord. And you can tell by the cover, I mean, this concept art looks fantastic, and the cover is right along those lines. And sort of rebooting the series, you know, he's this prince, he's never known peace, but now this new war is breaking out, and of course, he has to reacquire the most powerful weapon in the universe and become Exo Manowar once again. It looks really awesome. Of course, for anybody who's a 90s comic book fan, a fan of Valiant, or a fan of good sci-fi, you should definitely go pick up Exo Manowar number one and welcome Valiant back in the 21st century. So, while we're on the subject of comics, let's talk a little comic book news. This is about Incredible Hulk. Now, there have been two lukewarm Incredible Hulk movies in the last decade or so. Ang Lee did one that was kind of slow. It was very much a character examination with Eric Bana. Then there was the much more awesome, well, action-wise, Incredible Hulk that had Edward Norton playing that title character, and that was really cool. But then, you know, all that dissolved before Avengers, so now we have Mark Ruffalo playing the Hulk in the Avengers movie. Well, it ends up that the reaction to the Hulk has been so positive, so overwhelmingly positive, that the people behind all this, you know, the Marvel Entertainment people, are really starting to think, well, maybe we could have another Hulk movie sometime in a few years, so maybe 2015. Now, they had pretty much abandoned the idea of doing any more Hulk movies after the first two, but they're saying with Ruffalo's take on the character and the way that they've sort of re-aimed it, it's more of a, you know, inspirational and heroic character rather than the simply misunderstood giant. And apparently people are really gravitating to that a lot more. But there's also a new TV show in the works, and you know, over the next few years, they can definitely do a lot with merchandising and whatnot to build up the Hulk brand and figure out if there's a place for it. And you know, I'm sure Mark Ruffalo wouldn't mind the work as Bruce Banner. So that's it for comics this week. We'll see you next time.